And a good morning to you. Welcome back outside. Clear to partly cloudy skies. Couple of spots seeing a little bit of rainfall. Let's go right to the radar. You know, this morning, this time, in the mornings during this time of year, we usually get a couple of spotty showers cruising on shore, and that's the case right now as we speak. You can see way off the coast there, south of Alabama right here. There's Alabama. There's some showers there. But a little bit closer to home, here's what we're dealing with, Lafourche Parish. You see one little thunderstorm there, rather high. You see that a little red there indicating that, yeah, it's a little thunderstorm activity moving just right around Lake Salvador. Otherwise, not seeing a whole lot. A little bit of one little spotty shower south of Des Almonds and also right around the marsh area there in Terrebonne Parish. As we move through the morning and then get into the afternoon, showers and storms will be bubbling up once again. 75 right now in Slidell, 78 in Gulfport, 81 at the Lakefront Airport, and 82 down around Grand Island. This is pretty standard fare, so not a whole lot's going to change. Different day, pretty much same weather. It's going to be hot, humid, scattered showers and storms in the afternoon. And tropics, we are tracking the tropics because now, you know, yesterday, of course, was the 20th, and we start seeing a rise. I'm going to show you a little graph here, but Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean right now looking good. But let me show you what's going on. We got a couple of spots where we're seeing these upper-level lows here. There's one right there. There's Cuba. There's another one off the coast. That's actually going to move across and help increase our rain chances today. And then another one over Mexico. So right now, the upper-level lows, that's not good for tropical cyclone development, nor is all this dry air out here in the tropical Atlantic. Here's another upper low, so you throw in the upper low, the dry air, anything that comes off of Africa is going to have a difficult time getting going. Now, this is probably not going to last. Here's what I'm talking about as we look at some historical data here. Yesterday, of course, was the 20th, and notice we do spike in activity, rising up to about September 10th. So while it is quiet right now, we'll take it for as long as we can. I am anticipating a bit rise in the activity to increase as we continue through hurricane season. Right now, though, just a couple of spotty showers. I showed you them on the radar imagery. A little bit of cloud cover. This model is showing some of that rainfall kind of lingering by 9 a.m. And then by later on in the afternoon, we start working in some daytime heating, a couple upper air impulses. I think 40%, that's a good coverage number for this afternoon. And then overnight tonight, the rain goes away. Tomorrow morning, coastal showers. You've heard this story before, right? And then tomorrow afternoon, when we get this big, broad area of green, that usually means that it's about a 30% chance of rain. There's some cloud in there. There's some moisture. I don't think we see as much rain tomorrow as I'm anticipating for this afternoon. By 10 o'clock, the rain goes away, and we lose the daytime heating. That's why. So not much change. Upper 80s, lower 90s for this afternoon. Rain chances slightly better than yesterday at about 40%. It'll be hot and humid before the rain arrives. Clear to partly cloudy overnight tonight. A few isolated showers will be possible. It'll be muggy. Temperatures mid-70s for the most part. And your 7-day exactcast is showing, as we were yesterday, about a 30 to 40% chance of rain right through the forecast period. And your afternoon temperatures, they're going to stay in the upper 80s to lower 90s. Morning lows in the mid to upper 70s. Mayor, as you look at weather, Randy, back to you.
Thank you, Jim.